गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, आई एम रुचिका, योर इंग्लिश टीचर फ्रॉम स्प्रिंग फील्ड पब्लिक स्कूल. वी वर डूइंग लेसन नंबर 7, पिप्स एडवेंचर, एंड वी हैव रेड पेज नंबर 59, 60 एंड 61. नाउ वी विल कॉन्टिन्यू दिस लेसन. टेक आउट योर बुक्स ऑन पेज नंबर 61, लास्ट पैराग्राफ ऑफ दिस पेज. पिप रैन होम without stopping. Joe was sitting in the chimney corner and told him Mrs. Joe had been out to look for him and taken Tickler with her. What is Tickler? Tickler was a cane, stick. Underline this. Pip was rather depressed by this piece of news. Next page, 62. Mrs. Joe came in almost directly. And after having given Pip a taste of Tickler, she sat down to prepare the tea and cutting a huge slice of bread and butter. She gave half of it to Joe and half to Pip. Pip managed after some time to slip his piece down the leg of his trousers, and Joe, thinking he had swallowed it, was dreadfully alarmed and begged him not to bolt his food. Bolt his food here means swallow his food, like that. Pip, old chap, you will do yourself a mischief. It will stick somewhere. You can't have chewed it, Pip. You know, Pip, you and me is always friends. And I would be the last to tell upon you at any time. But such a most uncommon bolt as that. Uncommon means abnormal. Poor Pip passed a rest night. Rest means unhappy, sad night. Underline and write it down the meaning. Thinking of the dreadful promise he had made, and as soon as it was beginning to get light outside, he got up and crept downstairs. Crept downstairs means move slowly, very slowly downstairs. As quickly as he could, he took some bread, some cheese, about half a jar of mince meat. He tied up in a handkerchief with the previous night's slice of bread and butter, a meat bone with very little on it, and a pie, which he found on an upper shelf. Then he got a file from among Joe's tools and ran for the marshes. He is taking so many things. Bread, cheese, mince meat in a handkerchief, and bread and butter and pie, and file from among Joe's tools. Why? For whom? That all the things for convict. Next, page number 63. Pip found the man waiting for him. Who was the man, children? The man was the convict. Half dead with cold and hunger, and he ate the food in such a ravenous way. Ravenous means extremely hungry, that Pip, in spite of his terror, was quite pitiful over him and said, "I am glad you enjoy it." "Thank you, my boy, I do." Pip watched him trying to file the iron off his leg, and then, being afraid of stopping longer away from home, he ran off. Pip passed a rest morning. Rest, you know, I had given the meaning already. Expecting every moment that the disappearance of the pie, disappearance means missing, would be found out. But Mrs. Joe was too much taken up with preparing the dinner, for they were expecting visitors. Mrs. Joe was expecting visitors. Page number 64. At the end of the dinner, Pip was scared that he would be found out when his sister graciously called out to be guest, out to her guest. "You must taste a most delightful and delicious present I have had. It's a pie. Pie. A savory pie." Savory means salty, spicy, but not sweet. Pip could bear it no longer and ran for the door, and ran head foremost into a party of soldiers with their muskets. It is given. Muskets means soldiers with their rifles, one of whom held out a pair of handcuffs to him. You can see in the picture They, the soldiers, have a handcuff in their hand. Here and to him saying, "Here you are, look sharp, come on." But they had not come for him. They only wanted Jaw to mend the handcuffs. The soldiers visited Mr. Jaw to mend the handcuffs. To mend means to repair the handcuffs. For they were on the search of two convicts. What for? You can underline. For means because they were on the search for two convicts who had escaped and were hidden in the marshes. This turned the attention of Mrs. Jaw from the disappearance of the pipe. Now Mrs. Jaw turned the attention that her pie is missing from the kitchen. When the handcuffs were mended, means repaired, the soldiers went off, accompanied by Jaw and one of the visitors. Jaw took Pip and carried him on his back. Pip whispered, "I hope, Jaw, we shall not find him." And Jaw answered, "I would give a shilling if they had cut and run, Pip." Shilling means paise, paisas. But the soldiers soon caught them, and one was Pip's miserable acquaintance. And once, when the man looked at Pip, the child shook his head to try and let him know he had said nothing. But the convict, without looking at anyone, told the sergeant he wanted to say something to prevent other people being under suspicion, and said he had taken some victuals. Victuals means food. Underline and write down the meaning. From the blacksmith. It was some broken victuals. That's what it was, and a pie. "Have you happened to miss such an article as a pie, blacksmith?" inquired the sergeant. "My wife did at the very moment when you came in." "So," said the convict, looking at Jaw, "you are the blacksmith, are you? Then I'm sorry to say I have eaten your pie." "God knows you are welcome to it," said Jaw. "We don't know what you have done, but we wouldn't have you starve to death for it. Poor, miserable fellow creature. Would us, Pip?" Page number 66. Then the boat came and the convicts were taken back to prison, and Jaw carried Pip home. A few years later, a mysterious friend sent money for Pip to be educated. The mysterious man, friend, who is a mysterious friend? The convict. And brought up as a gentleman. It was only when Pip was quite grown up that he discovered this mysterious friend was a wretched convict who had frightened him so dreadfully that cold, dark Christmas Eve. That's all. The lesson is over, children. And in the next lecture, I'll send you question answers. Write that question answers in your notebook. Thank you. Have a nice day.